The first thing to do when you receive your HuddlePod Air is read through the included manual. Note, your HuddlePod Air includes a 3-year warranty, and if you ever have questions about how this product operates, you can always call our support team. As you unbox your HuddlePod Air, you will find the speakerphone, the wireless USB receiver, a Neoprene travel case, the user manual, a USB charging block, and a USB 2.0 cable, which is used for charging. Now it is time to charge your wireless speakerphone. A fully charged HuddlePod Air can operate for 7 hours of audio conferencing. Many times, users will connect the included USB charging cable to a power source instead of relying on the battery power. When one end of the USB cable is inserted into the USB port on the device, and the other end to the USB port on the computer or to a USB power supply, power will be supplied to the device and the built-in battery will be charged. At the same time, the device will be powered on automatically. Upon full charging, the bottom right indicator will turn orange and stay on when in standby mode. In case of low battery during use, the LEDs above the buttons will begin to flash. In this case, use the USB cable to charge the built-in battery as soon as possible. Once your HuddlePod Air is significantly charged or connected to a power source directly, it is time to connect your wireless USB 2.0 transceiver. This device is compatible with the following operating systems: Microsoft Windows, Android, and Mac OS X. A USB 2.0 or higher port is required. The USB wireless adapter supplied with the device is plug and play without the need of a custom driver installation. Note, this 2.4 GHz wireless digital conference phone is ideal for high-end audio/video conferencing. You will notice it is perfect for any software-based conferencing system as soon as you plug it in. Tip: the HuddlePod Air should make itself the default speaker for your computer once it is plugged in. You can check this out in the sound settings by right-clicking the speaker icon and clicking Open Sound Settings in Windows. You can manually select your default microphone and speaker settings inside your sound control panel. Once plugged in, the HuddlePod Air will be made available to your favorite conferencing software. Let's open up Skype and try it out. Press and hold the power button until the device is turned on and enter standby mode. In this state, the bottom right blue lights blinks continuously, waiting for a receiver to be connected. When the USB wireless adapter is connected to the USB port on the computer, the USB driver will be automatically recognized on the computer. The triangular blue light will now stop blinking and stay on, suggesting a successful wireless connection between the device and the computer. Note: only connect one speaker device to the PC at a time. Connect the USB wireless adapter directly to the PC rather than through a USB hub, or some operational problems can arise. Now that our HuddlePod Air is connected to our computer, let's review the available buttons on top of our speakerphone. From left to right, we have speaker mute, volume down, power on off, volume up, and microphone mute. You'll notice that there are LED lights indicators above each button on top of the HuddlePod Air. The LED corresponding to the button will illuminate when toggled on. For example, the LED will illuminate over the mute microphone mute button when muted. When the loudspeaker is set within its normal operating parameters, these lights are off. When the built-in battery level is low, the LEDs above the buttons will begin to flash. When fully charged, the orange light stays on when in standby mode. This device can be used as an external speaker for computer equipment. Using music player software on the computer, you can hear music playback through the speaker on the device. Also, a headphone can be connected to the 3.5mm audio output port on the device, or an active speaker can be connected to realize high-quality amplification of wider-range speech broadcasting and music playback. You have now successfully set up your HuddlePod Air. If you have questions about your HuddlePod Air, feel free to give us a call on the phone number listed on our website, or open up a support ticket at help.huddlecamhd.com. Enjoy!